Alright guys, today I'm going to show you how to make as much coins as possible day 1 of MUT 19. Starting off right away, as you level up, you do get access to quick sell packs that actually make you a decent amount of coins, not too much. So, starting off right away, we have to start off with solo challenges. This is the best way to make coins day 1. First off, we have the campaign solos, which once you go ahead and complete all these solo challenges, you will receive a lot of coins just by going ahead and completing them. You also receive 287 overall players. Offense and defense, we'll look at those players in 1 second. But as you can see, as you go through, you will receive campaign token packs. Again, very, very nice way to make coins is just grinding out these solos. They do take some time, but at the same time, you do get other players. Like, you get a gold kicker fantasy pack. You get, going through here, you get a gold punter fantasy pack and elite defensive player pack. So you're going to get a lot of good players just by going ahead and completing these solos. The campaign is like Journey. It takes a little longer, but still, it's going to be worth it. Also, you do get Journey at level 30. So, grinding out solos. Number one, to make coins. Number two is going to be going ahead and leveling up. As you level up, you do receive a lot of different packs. You also receive a lot of different quick sells. And also, once you hit level 30, as I said, you get the journey unlocked. Once you go ahead and hit level 30, you're able to go ahead and do the journey. And that's going to get you a lot of coins and an 89 overall cost and wins. Now, going ahead and as you level up, you also will get daily quick sells. And just like last year's daily quick sells are no different. As you level up, the quick sell amount will go higher and higher, starting at 50,000 coins, going all the way up to 350,000 coins as you go higher than that. Now, of course, other ways to make coins is through the objectives. As you can see right here, MUT levels awards. As you go higher up, you will go ahead and earn enough XP to receive a team item fantasy pack award. So again, you saw right at the beginning of this video, it was the quick sell pack. And I'm pretty sure as you go higher and higher, you will receive more and more stuff from that. Of course, we also have this, which will not go ahead and it does not look like it rewards you for. Okay, so I think it rewards you some coins. I'm trying to figure this out because you see right here it says get rewarded for 125,000, 250,000, 501,125,000 total offensive yards. So that does go ahead and give, I think, gives you some rewards with coins. But, of course, going ahead and doing MUT Master will also get you coins. Go ahead and completing MUT Master completely, this whole entire stat list, it will go ahead and give you 250,000 coins. And, of course, you get even more coins for going ahead and completing Shazier's stat list. And, of course, you have this list right here, which is, of course, MUT Master. So, completing MUT Master total gets you 750,000 coins between these two categories. Other ways to make coins is going to be going ahead and doing these, you know, typical solo challenge, solo battles, objectives, improve your overalls will go ahead and get you a lot of coins. As you remember last year, you could get up to 250,000 coins by just going to a 95 overall. It does take some time, but 250,000 coins for that is not bad. You will just level up normally as you get more and more players on your team, as you do solos, as you snipe, as you do all that kind of good stuff. So, of course, right here we have the launch weekly objective list, which does also get you coins. Now, for the more advanced users, we do have a beautiful thing called sniping. Now, if you guys are new to Madden Ultimate Team, you might not know what sniping is. Pretty much the whole principle behind sniping is buying a card for cheap, reselling it for a lot of coins. I will make a separate video in about 10 minutes going ahead and covering everything when it comes to sniping and also the best sniping filters day one. But pretty much the whole idea is you go ahead and you just try to buy one of these cards. Let's say, for example, let's go ahead and go to a random card. Let's say we have, you know, 88. Oh, okay. So right now, Rob Gronkowski is 500,000 coins. Let's say we have Rob Gronkowski as an example, right? Let's say someone puts him up. Let's say he's selling consistently for 500,000 coins, right? Let's say someone puts him up for 100,000 coins. The idea is you go through the auction block, different filters, to see if anyone puts these cards up for crazy, ridiculous prices. You can snipe them real fast within a second and resell them and make a huge profit. Now, most of the time, the big boy snipes like Gronkowski, you're not going to get them. It's very, very difficult to get these kind of snipes. You're going to have to go ahead and more or less bank on the smaller snipes. The 82s, the 83s, the 80 overall, 81s. And right now, the marketplace is just completely dead on PC. But that's the whole premise behind it, is you want to go ahead and bank on the smaller snipes, which is going to make you the more profit overall-wise because it's consistent profit. Another thing we have is going to be this exact thing you see right here. There are certain base elites that have quick sell values up to 500,000 coins. And if you get a player with this quick sell value, this little, you see coins on his card, that means he has a huge quick sell value. Jared Cook is actually a 20,000 coin quick sell value. These cards go up to 500,000 coins. There's an Andrew Luck with 500,000 quick sell. So when you're pulling packs, if you make sure you look out for this little icon right there, that little coin icon. Because that coin icon means this card has a lot of coins quick sell wise. So just keep that in mind. I think all the base elites have that. Every single base elite card, I believe, has a quick sell card that goes for a lot. So again, if you get one crazy thing like that, you can make a lot of good coins, and that's pretty much awesome. Of course, going through the solo challenges, if you do the intro solos, you do get a team captain pack. Now, this team captain pack does not go ahead and reward you any kind of coin value, but you're able to go ahead and choose your team captain for the year, and you get some training points. So if you're looking to get some extra training points, go ahead and do the team captain pack, and you get to go ahead and, you know, of course, get your team captain. Other than that, though, of course, we're going to talk about this later in the season, but I'll cover it now. A good way to make coins is investing. And investing comes down to different promos in the game. When different promos are in the game, you're able to go ahead and, you know, buy and sell cards at a certain value and make a lot of coins. A good example of that, and again, I'll run this down. This will be probably like a 10-part series of how to make coins. But what I'm trying to say right here is that, for example, let's say there's a promo pack in the store. Whenever there's a promo pack in the store, Team of the Week, Veterans, whatever it may be, all those cards in that pack go down in value. And when they go down in value and they go to like 200, 500, 600 coins, it's a good idea to buy those cards, store them, so once those packs are out of the store, you can sell those cards back and actually make a killing when it comes to coins. And I know it might sound stupid, but you can buy, like, let's say 60, 200 coin cards, and then once the packs are out of the store, and let's say they do have a set you had to complete, those cards go up to 1,000, 1,200, 1,500. If you do the math there, right, and we go ahead and let's do the math here. We take 60 cards, right, and we sell them for 1,500 coins. That's 90,000 coins you make from going ahead and doing that, right? So, and you, if you want to do the math there, you went ahead and bought them, let's say, for 300 coins each. That's 18,000. So 90,000 minus 18,000 is going to be 72,000 coin profit. Now, let's say you do that each and every single week. This is just one little branch on how to make coins through so many different branches. This little branch of 72,000 coins, that's going to go ahead and make you some pretty quick dough very, very quickly. And again, this is just one little thing. We have the investing, which you can invest into the promos. You can hold cards for a certain amount of time, knowing that they're going to get a power upset or whatever may be the case, and sell them back and make a killing of a profit. Now, I have to talk about this just because this is technically a way to make coins, but it's not really the way I would go. You can buy packs. You can buy points and buy packs. You see right here, yes, you can do that. If you go ahead and buy this bundle, you will make a lot of coins back. If you buy these packs, you will make a lot of coins back. That's just how it works. It's, you know, it is Madden for a reason. It is paid to win. That's how Madden works, and that's how Madden will always work. At the end of the day, though, I do not recommend buying packs. I do not recommend spending money in this game. You can play this game, have fun, make millions of coins, and not spend a dime. Trust me, guys, before I started on YouTube, you know, all the time, I used to play Madden Ultimate Team, 12, 13, 25, and 13. And then, of course, well, 13, 25, 15, and 16, I did not spend a dime in Ultimate Team. I had 99 of all teams. I had these crazy, insane, you know, coin amounts like 10 million, 15 million, and I didn't spend a dime in the game. I'll never forget this. I mention this every time I start a Ultimate Team, and I tell you guys how to make coins. I, one time when I invested, I believe, into like 80 elite badges. Now, of course, elite tokens, but back in the day, they were elite badges. I invested 80 elite badges at 10k a piece, and they went up to around 60k. Now imagine that profit share. Let's go ahead and I'm not going to do that profit share right now, but you guys understand what I'm trying to say. My coins went from 10K elite badges, right? 80 of them to 60K elite badges. Just like that. 50K profit on all those cards. If I'm doing math off the top of my head, that's 4.5 million. I believe that's correct math. If I'm doing it incorrect, I do not believe it's 45 million or else I would be rowing in dough because I would have sold those coins. Nonetheless, though, last way to make coins is through doing sets. When you go ahead and go to the sets, you of course you have your loyalty sets, which you get day one. When you go ahead and log in Ultimate Team, you can go ahead and put your loyalty stuff in there and you get stuff back. Of course, doing some sets will go ahead and risk coins. So, for example, if you go ahead and do the flashback sets, the veteran sets, that will risk you losing coins just because of the fact it does go ahead and, you know, it's a risk-reward type of scenario. So, of course, we have all token sets, which currently tokens... It does not look like the... Oh, sorry. This is earned tokens. Sorry, my bad. Player packs, classic packs. So, flashbacks. Again, these are risk-reward scenarios. You cannot buy tokens off the auction block. So, you can't invest in the tokens, which does suck. But going ahead and doing these sets could be a risk-reward. You could pull someone insane and make a lot of coins. Or you could pull someone awful and make no coins. It just comes down to random luck. If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to like and subscribe button. Hopefully this did help you out day one to make some good coins. And hopefully you guys understood the principles on how to make coins. And yes, it is very, very easy to make coins. It is not challenging in any context. And trust me, I'm going to, again, as I said, I'm going to do a 10 part series to how to make coins. Again, you can go ahead and do solo battles, which is also a great way to make coins. I almost forgot to mention this. Going through, as you can see, you go ahead and complete these solos. You do go ahead and get some ranks up. You rank up, you get some coin rewards. You see right here, rank one gets you 250,000 coins, 20 trophies, 2 Hail Mary packs, 2 midfield packs, 2 red zone packs, and 5 touchdown packs. But even if you're not that good at Madden, let's say you're just decent, every single week you can go ahead and, let's say you get silver every single week. That's still 2 Hail Mary packs, 15,000 coins, and 3 trophies. For literally, honestly, you could probably do nothing good in these solo battle games and still get a lot of coins. Another great thing is that it is against CPU. It is not against someone online, meaning no one play touchdown, not one play over and over again, and you're getting destroyed and it's just annoying to play against. That's something that's not going to happen when you're playing the CPU. Yes, the CPU is annoying, but it's not as bad. Of course, you can go ahead and do some MUT squads if you want to. You can earn some coins through MUT squads, which is not too bad. Of course, we have MUT squads versus CPU, which you see right here. As you go ahead and do them, you can go ahead and get some coin rewards, which, again, not bad. Also, you get XP, which helps you out to level up, which I said before is a great way to make coins. We also have MUT draft, which is not bad at all. Same premise as last year, you had to pay your way in. So you had to buy tickets. In order to buy tickets, you had to go ahead and then you go ahead and you win prizes depending on how long you last. Now you see right here, going ahead and it takes a level 10 to go ahead and unlock. So we cannot play that at the moment. Can we see the rewards? Here we go. So here are the rewards for going ahead and doing MUT draft, which is honestly not that bad with the fact it does cost 5 tickets, and I believe 5 tickets is not that much. Let's go ahead and check out what 5 tickets will cost. So again, depending on how good you are at Madden, you can go ahead and either play the CPU make coins, or you can play against actual people and make coins. Alright, so 5 tickets is 15,000 coins, which is not bad. I mean, it does cost some coins, but again, it takes coins to make coins. That's the premise. Nonetheless, guys, that's pretty much it. Other than that, there's, like, for this intro video, that's the main principles on how to make coins day one of MUT 19. Tell me down below your thoughts and opinions. I love to hear them. I said this before, but if you're playing with EA Access, sell every living card you can sell day one, because the fact of the matter is, when day one comes on August 7th, it's going to be a whole different ball club, because now you have so many people playing the game that everyone's going to be opening up packs. Trust me, you might think a lot of people are playing EA Access right now. It's not. It's going to be completely different when you go ahead and get the full game on August 7th. Thank you guys for watching. Peace out.